Okay, squad, remember. We get the package, and we get out. Breaking the doors. This is a mess.
My name is Hrvoje Horvatek. I'm the CEO of IronWard.
Tell us about your game.
So, Red Solstice 2, it's basically a game where you can play alone or up to 8 players. And it has a strategy layer and a combat layer. Mm-hmm. And it's like a real-time tactics, claustrophobic, atmospheric action.
Very nice. Tell us more about the combat in the game. As much as I played, I like saw that there are many different ways to approach the combat of the game. Mm-hmm. Tell us more about it.
Okay, so before you approach the combat layer, you have to research some technologies. And based on technologies you have researched in your strategy layers by doing missions or stuff, you will have a certain abilities and components that you can customize your character with. Mm-hmm. You have 8 classes, and you can customize the character to be more stealthy, to be more in combat, to be more like fortified, like a bunker. And based on your abilities, this is how the combat will play out. For example, you played an assault, which is a kind of a generic class that is good at everything. And he's good at shooting, good at sprinting, good at melee, he has a bit of everything. Mm-hmm. So as you played it, there was Overwatch, which targets the enemies, like on corridors, fast, but it's not good versus masses. Mm-hmm. Then you had like a manual aim, which makes you much more powerful, but much more slower, but you manually direct your fire. And at the end, you had like L and B to select targets. Mm-hmm. And there were different creatures, basically, which you were encountering, and you had to decide how to use it, and which items to use, which you picked up, explored, and how to approach the combat. So it's more like, it's not pure action, it's more like think up front and decide mm-hmm. which action you want to take based on the components and customization you made in your armory.
Okay. Tell us more about the level design. Like, you told us about how levels like change earlier, so tell us more about that.
Okay, so each time you start a level, there will be like part of the level will be procedurally generated. Rooms will be changed, the objectives will be changed. So each time you play the level, it might be similar, it will not be the same. It's not fully procedurally generated, just up to some point. So that each time you have a new experience, but rely on the known data. So if you visited Terraformer once or twice, you will know the general layout, but it will change a bit. Mm-hmm. So this will help you with your mission, like the knowledge that you had from before. And once you reached one point of the mission, when the infestation started to spread, the level changed. It means that a lot of more creatures started spawning below you, like certain tentacles will start to grow, and you will have to encounter, you will encounter new barricades. And in the future, you will be able to burn or destroy that infestation, and this will create safe areas for you. So you'll have to decide, maybe you want to take flamethrowers into the level, which cost a lot of resources, but are very powerful weapons, or you might want to go all guns blazing, or maybe you want to take liquid nitrogen to capture some creatures and bring them to your HQ.
Nice. So, co-op, will the game have couch co-op?
No, it's one computer, one player.
Okay.
So it's up to 8 players. And basically, that's it. And one cool thing is that if you start a campaign in a strategy layer and you research your own technologies, and if a friend joins you, he can join you with their own technologies and play with your technologies.
So you can share.
You can share. And there will be like multiple factions you can play with, and each will have their own like agendas, motives, and stuff. So at one point, you'll have to decide, do you want to steal technology from another faction? Or do you want to maybe save some civilians?
Okay.
And since the game is called Red Solstice 2 Survivors, it's all about saving the planet. So if you work for your greedy corporation too much, you might kill all the people in the meantime.
Okay.
So you have to basically balance your decisions, and the map will change and the level will change as you do this.
So multiple endings confirmed.
Yes.
Very nice. Well, thank you. When will we be able to play the game at our homes?
Next year.
Next year. Very nice. Thank you for the interview. It was very nice playing the game. Can't wait for it. Anything else you want to say?
Well, if you like the game, if you like what you're hearing, add it to your wish list and follow us. Support us.
Will do. Thank you.
Thank you.